interesting as time goes on, and eventually the showers there will be replaced by, silly as it was last night, we actually had a touch of frost in one or two spots, but even so, it will be a little bit on the cool side. Well, that's all. A very good morning to you.
Grandstand is about to take BBC One through until tea time. As an alternative this afternoon, Rock Week on BBC Two opens with Elvis Presley and G.I. Blues. That's at 3:10 this afternoon. So now on BBC One at 10:55, Grandstand with Frank Boff.
Hello, very good morning to you. Well, I promise you a really good grandstand day ahead of us, full of splendid events.
The afternoon to see further play.
Well, here they are behind me in all their glory, our football boards on the new day of a season, and whatever problems face the game of football, and there are some, aren't there? It still remains a great game, and with the opening day of a new season always comes that keen sense of anticipation amongst the fans who always look for the good things in the game, and rightly so, there are many of those too. How will the champions do on the first day? And that's usually Liverpool. How will the newly promoted get on, like Watford, the newly arrived, like Keegan at St James's Park? So it's a time for optimism, and Grandstand looks forward to it all as keenly as anybody. Well, in a moment, we have a terrific football focus, which lays out all the issues, well spiced with action, and then after kick-off time, the early scores, with a full round-up at half-time. Nowhere do you get the results quicker than from our famous videoprinter at 4:40, and that will be closely followed by eyewitness reports, interviews, and pools news. So, do start the new season with Grandstand in just a moment when I've told you what else we have on the programme today.
60 BBC Years brings a tour around the BBC as it is now in a distinctly individual Terry Wogan guide to the BBC tomorrow night at 9:25.
BBC One starts a new series of Juliet Bravo next Saturday, and the first crime facing Inspector Darblay is an attempted murder.
Reed's a soldier, so watch it if you find him. He's just wounded a man.
Hartley Police Force is stretched to the limit when the hunt for the attacker begins, but Jean gets no help from his family.
Will his dad call us if he comes home? Not.
The case is further complicated when some guns are stolen.
See the chief super. Get the firearms team in. Put a full-scale alert out. Nail him up.
If he had the guns, Harry. If, then I might.
He'd have no option, chief.
As you say, but right now I don't think he has the guns.
A new series of Juliet Bravo starts next Saturday at 7:50. Part of the complete entertainment coming to BBC One.
Now, before farming, we're showing the first of this week's special interlude films in celebration of the BBC's 60 years. The Windmill at Pakenham, Bury St Edmunds.
Thank you.
This is BBC One. Now at 5 to 1, here's our farming programme live from our Pebble Mill studios and introduced by Dan Cherrington.
Good afternoon.
Not wishing to draw a comparison, but later on another institution comes under scrutiny as Terry Wogan acts as guide to the BBC in an individual fashion, rather akin to turning over a stone. That's at 9:25.
You can get power crazed in this place. Give old Auntie Bee her ball back.
From the BBC of the present, the days when radio ruled supreme, somehow without Terry Wogan. They recalled later in this anniversary week from the start of the British Broadcasting Company in 1922 to the coronation in 1953. John Snagg, Henry Hall, Winford Vaughan Thomas, Vera Lynn, David Davis, and the original Dick Barton, Noel Johnson, are some who remember those radio times on Friday night at 9:25 on BBC One.
Bank Holiday Monday and
in a couple of minutes on BBC One, a look at the weather to come, but as a reminiscence of time past, of 60 BBC years, an interlude. There's another interlude from about the same period, the early 60s, in the morning at 10 to 11 on BBC One, messing about on the river. And now here's the weatherman, Michael Fish.
Good evening to you. It looks as if there'll be a fair number of showers around tomorrow to catch out the...
There's a variety of programmes appropriate for Bank Holiday Monday with B.A. Robertson. Now it's nearly 9 minutes past midnight, and for solace throughout the night, there's always Radio 2, BBC One is back in the morning at 9:05, but for now, from us at the BBC Television Centre, have a very pleasant Bank Holiday Monday, and good night.
This afternoon on BBC One Disney Time, Kenny Everett introduces excerpts from Fantasia, Mary Poppins, Robin Hood and Watcher in the Woods, all in the best possible taste at 5:25. In a couple of minutes, the holiday weather. First an interlude film, first shown in the early 1960s, Messing About on the River.
When the weather is fine, then you know it's a sign for messing about on the river. If you take my advice, there's nothing so nice as messing about on the river. There are longboats and shortboats and all sorts of craft, and cruisers and keelboats and some with no draft. So take off your coat and hop in a boat. Go messing about on the river. There are boats made from kit that reach you in fit for messing about on the river. Or you might like to scowl in a glass fiber hull, just messing about on the river. There are tillers and rudders and anchors and cleats and ropes that are sometimes referred to as sheep. With the wind in your face, there's no finer place than messing about on the river. There are skippers and mates and rowing clubs just messing about on the river. There are pontoons and trucks and all sorts of knots for messing about on the river. With thin boards and outboards and dinghies you sail, the first thing you learn is the right way to bail. In a one-seat canoe, you're the skipper and crew, just messing about on the river. Bridges and blocks and moorings and docks when messing about on the river. There's a whirlpool and weir that you mustn't go near when messing about on the river. There are backwater places all hidden from view and quaint little islands just awaiting for you. So I'll leave you right now to cast off your bow. Go messing about on the river.
In a few minutes, we're showing another nostalgic interlude from BBC Television's post-war years. This time, the location is Jamaica, where we're soothed by the sight of a palm beach. To take us there, here's some guitar music called Blue Part Invention, which was often heard on BBC Television between 1963 and 1965.
Thank you.
from Headingley follows in a few minutes. Before that, we hope to revive a few memories by showing a nostalgic interlude film used on BBC television during the 1950s, Palm Beach. There's another of these nostalgic interludes just before 3:40 this afternoon. Its title is Flirtation Waltz. Now, at the time approaching 5 to 11, we visit Headingley for cricket, the final day in the third test. This is BBC One.
England, 29 more runs to get. Pakistan, another 4 wickets. Who'd have thought when England yesterday were 168 for 1 that we were due for a finish as dramatic?
In a few moments, Interlude, another of those little films that filled the gaps on your television screens back in the 50s and 60s. Then after that, the singer Bernadette Grevy will be talking to Richard Baker in Home on Sunday. now, just before Home on Sunday, a little nostalgia. Here's a television interlude called Flirtation Waltz. Our next interlude will be at 11:50 this evening. From the early 50s, it's the self-explanatory Rough Sea on Rocks. And you can see another little piece of BBC history at 4:45 this afternoon, when Blue Peter flies the world and offers John Noakes death-defying free-fall parachute jump from 5 miles high. Now, on BBC One, a second showing Blue Peter. Helping to celebrate 60 BBC years from 1973, John Noakes drops in with The Long Fall.
In 1973, I achieved a great ambition, to jump from a plane 5 miles high and freefall from a greater height than any other British civilian. The RAF's famous Flying Falcon said I could join their crack display team.
Back to tonight now, and at 11 o'clock we go back 20 years for an episode of the immensely popular series starring Rupert Davis as Maigret. And now, from 10 years ago, Tom Clark's play, which was directed by Jack Gold and won the 1972 BAFTA and Writers Guild Awards. Brian Marshall, Jane Lapater and Gareth Thomas had the cast of Stocker's Copper.
This film is based on events that took place in Cornwall in the summer of 1913.
This is BBC One. Now it's time for tonight's little bit of nostalgia as we go back to 1962 for an episode starring Rupert Davis in the role for which he's probably best remembered, Chief Inspector Maigret. tomorrow evening, Bertie Wooster and the ever-resourceful Jeeves are involved in the delayed exit of Claude and Eustace as we move to 1966 for one of those incredible tangles starring Ian Carmichael and Dennis Price. P.G. Woodhouse's The World of Wooster is tomorrow at 10:35. In a couple of minutes, Michael Fish will be here with the stark reality of the late-night weather forecast. But first, let the nostalgia continue with one of our Interlude films, which first rolled and crashed its way across the screen in the early 1950s. It's the one called, for obvious reasons, Rough Sea on Rocks. Well, in case you've just switched on, I'd better hastily point out that that wasn't the weather forecast, but with all that sea as a prelude, tonight's weatherman must be Michael Fish.
Thank you very much. I'll get my own back one day, or even maybe change my name, or perhaps both. Actually, that particular piece of film wasn't all that appropriate, because the seas will not be rough at all in the next few days. Quite a gentle breeze and a gentle look to the weather, as a matter of fact, with this area of high pressure not very far away.
We'll look at tomorrow night on BBC One. At 6:20, the Wednesday film is Carry On Cruising, with hijinks on the high seas, where most of the passengers are less interested in dining at the captain's table and more concerned with finding a bit of crumpet. Then at 7:50, there's a chance to see again, from the very beginning, the story of Audrey Forbes Hamilton and Richard Devere in To the Manor Born. There's a change of mood at 8:15, when Tomorrow's World at Large takes a serious, but certainly not a gloomy look, at old age and the frail final stages of life, as Judith Han meets the patients in Amersham Hospital's geriatric ward. After the 9 o'clock news, Chicago Stories at 9:25, followed by The World of Wooster at 10:35, and at 10 past 11, Sir Harold Wilk.
Good afternoon to you from BBC One. Good afternoon to you from BBC One. In a few minutes, we're showing another interlude film from the archives, this time Angelfish from the 1950s. It's followed by News Afternoon at 1. Now some music which was often heard on BBC television during the 1950s. Now on BBC One, in celebration of the BBC's 60 years, we're showing another of our interlude films, this time Angelfish from the early 1950s. What a shame there was no colour television in those days. Our next special interlude film is at 4:10 this afternoon, when you can see The Kitten, also first shown in the early 1950s. And at the end of tonight on BBC One, you can see that familiar 1950s spinning wheel. The first of its revolutions begins at 11:50. Now, News Afternoon with Richard Whitmore and Moira Stewart. The time is 1:00.
Good afternoon, Wednesday's headlines. The Polish authorities reveal that two demonstrators were shot dead when police put down yesterday's show of support for Solidarity.
Now on BBC One, in celebration of the BBC's 60 years, we're showing an interlude film from the 1950s, The Kitten. Thank you.
This is BBC One North. Good afternoon. This is...
The complete entertainment coming to BBC One includes a taste of the high life from Los Angeles to Hong Kong as Barry Norman mingles with the rich and the famous. And BBC One revisits some far-flung places with Alan Wicker, who sets out to retrace his first million miles with BBC television. The police crime squad are closely observed as they unravel a network of villains in Operation Carter. And BBC One's First Lady of the Animal Kingdom returns with the Woodhouse Roadshow, inviting dogs and their owners to go all around the country. Wildlife on One discovers a teddy bear's picnic where the grizzlies went fishing in a new series that's just part of the complete entertainment coming to BBC One.
A delve back into the past now on BBC One, celebrating 60 BBC years with Ian Carmichael as Bertie Wooster and Dennis Price as the faithful servant Jeeves in P.G. Woodhouse's The World of Wooster. Couple of minutes, Sir Harold Wilson reflects on the last phase of his political career in the 20th century remembered. And now on BBC One, here are the news headlines from Michael Burke. Another recollection of 60 BBC years now on BBC One before the weather with this interlude. Thank you.
Music, by the way, was Table Talk by Dolph Fondalinda and Music Muse in Mayfair by Vivian Ellis. The Potter's Wheel, filmed at Guildford in Surrey, perhaps the most faithful standby to the BBC television service in the 1950s, will be spinning again tomorrow lunchtime on BBC One at about 5 to 1. Well, now the weather, and here's Jack Scott.
Hello. As far as weather was concerned, we're a divided nation. Becomes cloudy with a little rain or drizzle. That's it. Good night, Jim.
The inevitable way of prefacing Monty Python's Flying Circus, celebrating 60 BBC years at 6.25. Medical Express is at 6.55. What? Now, it's 4 minutes past midnight, and BBC One is back in the morning at 9:20. Let me thank you for your company tonight, and from us at the BBC Television Centre, good night for now.
Memories from the 1950s when we showed the short interlude film about the Potter's Wheel. To take us there, some music which was often heard on BBC television in the 1960s. It's called Blue Part Invention. News Afternoon follows in just over 5 minutes. On BBC One before that, here's an interlude film from the early 1950s, Potter's Wheel from Guildford, Surrey. The next interlude film from BBC Television's past is rather more modern. First used as a bridge between children's programmes in 1971, it's all about Gooney birds taking off, and it begins this afternoon at 4:50.
Showing another of our celebratory interlude films from BBC Television's past. It's one which should appeal to children, and it was first shown in 1971. It's called Gooney Birds Taking Off. On BBC One, we're showing a children's interlude film, which was first screened in 1971, all about Gooney birds taking off. In 3 minutes, Play School, followed at 4:45 by the famous spinach-guzzling cartoon sailor, Popeye, starring in his all-new show, and with his amazing bursts of strength, he manages to provide some fantastic gymnastics.
A, to irritate you, and B, to provide work for one of our announcers.
Good evening. I'm the announcer who's just been given this job by the BBC, and I'd just like to say how grateful I am to the BBC for providing me with work, particularly at this time of year when things are a bit thin for us announcers.
Tomorrow night marks the end of BBC One's week celebrating 60 BBC years. And those radio times at 25 past nine revives memories of the wireless in the days before television began to creep into superiority at the time of the coronation. And a little later, Ned Sherrin introduces a review of the year 1962 as seen by the team of that pioneering television satire show, That Was the Week That Was. That was 20 years ago, that was, tomorrow night at 10 to 11. Also from two decades ago, before the weather on BBC One, a short interlude. Another interlude from about that same period, the early 1960s, at about 5 to 1 this Friday lunchtime. Well, after the weather of the last few days restored briefly from the gloom today, it may be tempting providence to ask Michael Fish for the holiday weather prospects.
Good evening to you. If you're off on holiday this weekend, it looks as if there'll be a good deal of dry, warm and sunny weather to be found. Actually, it may well turn out that the weather here in the southern parts is a good deal better than in some of the more popular resorts of the Mediterranean. But more about that in a minute. As far as this country goes, we're going to have this area of high pressure with us for the...
Now, it's very nearly 12 minutes past midnight. And here's where we part company on BBC One, although Radio 2 carries on throughout the night. BBC One is back in the morning at 20 past nine. But from us now at the BBC Television Centre, it's good night.
Early example of the music produced by the BBC's Radiophonic Workshop. This is BBC One. Now we revive a few memories from the early 1960s by showing an interlude film called Roadworks. The next celebratory interlude film was used as a children's week sequence in the 1960s, Toy Fair, and you can see it at 4:10 this afternoon. Now, News Afternoon on BBC One with Richard Whitmore and Moira Stewart. It's 1 o'clock.
Good afternoon. Friday's headlines. The Western banking system could be on the brink of collapse. That's what a former Chancellor of the Exchequer, Dennis Healey, says. The health secretary meets the nurses. Will he have any more money to offer them? The sappers return from the Falklands and tell of the menace of the mines.
And we hear for the first time what the Argentine airman thought of the British task force. Fiddling on the dole, a junior minister tells how the Social Security investigates to save the taxpayer millions. And those daring young men in their microlights set off for France.
A very good afternoon from BBC One. In just over 2 minutes, another chance to see one of those interlude films from the BBC television archives, Toy Fair. But first, some music heard every day on children's television during the 1950s. It's the Scherzetto for Children, played by the Eric Robinson Orchestra. Thank you. This is BBC One. And now, more memories from the television archives. Here's an interlude film first shown in 1966, Toy Fair.
Thank you.
there's a chance to travel from London to Brighton in 4 minutes tonight at 8.55 when we take another interlude from the BBC archives.
Good afternoon from BBC One North. This is Brian Baines with the regional news from the North Newsroom. An out-of-control goods train careered through Huddersfield Station today. The engine driver and the guard couldn't stop it, but they were able to slow it down and divert it to Hillhouse Sidings a mile away. They jumped clear just before it crashed into a stationary freight truck and escaped with slight injuries. Four trucks were derailed in the collision. British Rail officials are now investigating what caused the brakes to fail.
Russell Harty writes about this series in the current issue of The Listener.
Well, tomorrow night at 7.15, the return of Blankety Blank. They don't care, you know. And for the first time, Vincent Price, joined by Larry Grayson and Beryl Reed and David Hamilton and Carol Drinkwater and Patricia Brake. You won't want to miss it, will you?
In 25 minutes, BBC One goes back 60 years to the beginning of the British Broadcasting Company and recalls the stars and programmes of those radio times before the coronation in 1953. And a bit later, Ned Sherrin looks back to the pioneering television satire show he created at the beginning of the 60s, That Was the Week That Was, and presents the TW3 team's highly individual view of the world as they saw it 2 decades ago. That was 20 years ago, that was, at 10 to 11 tonight.
In this season of mists and mellow fruitfulness, one further gleam of light comes over the horizon in the form of Points of View, winging its way to Wednesday night on BBC One. If you have an opinion that you want to share, why don't you write to me at the BBC Television Centre, London W12 8QT. And join me Wednesday for the first of a new series of Points of View at 8.50 on BBC One.
This is BBC One, and here is the 9 o'clock news.
Dennis Healy warns of a total collapse of the Western banking system, anarchy and starvation. Nurses are told again, no more money, and the TUC calls for more strike action. The Ugandan Asians, thrown out by Amin, are now invited back. And the Princess of Wales at another wedding, as guest of honour. Good evening, Mr. Dennis Healy.
Radio Times brings a colourful look to BBC Television's new season. There's a glimpse into the future with pictures and stories about some of the programmes on BBC One and Two which will be brightening up the evenings in the next few weeks. A new series of Angels starts on Monday.
These are new students and they're not going to learn about wards and nothing sitting about in a classroom all day.
And you can read all about it in the new Radio Times. In at the Deep End is a new series in which Chris Searle and Paul Heine try a variety of jobs. And there's a colour article in the new Radio Times. The detective with a difference is back with a very different car chase. The Chinese detective in the new Radio Times. And a new drama series, Claire.
Shut up, you!
You're blushing.
I'm not dead.
Claire in the new Radio Times.
Oh, excuse me. Oh, if you have trouble getting up early in the morning, you need a late, late breakfast show. And I've got one. It's on at tea time, which is no mean feat. And I mean feat. Crumbs, where do they come from? The answer's in the new Radio Times.
Old Radio Times now on BBC One, all part of 60 BBC years. And a look back to the start of the British Broadcasting Company and the heyday of the wireless up to the coronation. Those radio times.
What is a wireless set?
No, I protest. We have proved the wireless set.
You have produced an article, but you have not established the nature of the article.
Very good.
Lord, look at it.
I am looking at it.
Life was a thrill for me.
I'm sorry, my lord, but the interruption was quite accidental.
Quite so. When I but alternatively, it is very pleasant. Please continue.
And Northern Ireland, there will be a good deal of cloud and a little rain or drizzle at times, with more persistent rain reaching Northern Ireland and Western Scotland during the afternoon. In the cloudier areas, the temperature will only reach 17 centigrade, 63 Fahrenheit. Grandstand tomorrow features cricket from Lords, Surrey against Warwickshire, the World Cycling Championships at Goodwood, racing from Haydock and eventing from Lumberland.
Grandstand starts at 5 to 10 in the morning. In 50 minutes, the late film is a wartime story, Hornet's Nest, stirred up by Rock Hudson and Selva Koshiner. Now, to end BBC One's week celebrating 60 BBC years, Ned Sherrin introduces the pioneering television satire show he created two decades ago in That Was 20 Years Ago, That Was.
Behind this handsome nationwide set is a real television studio. Just over 20 years ago, we did a pilot, a practice show for a new program against these bare studio walls. When the series went on the air, the walls were still bare, and the show was live and topical, and it was broadcast late every Saturday night. It lasted about an hour. It was called That Was the Week That Was. Many of you will not remember the program. Many of you will not remember the 1960s. Muhammad Ali was still Cassius Clay. You could go out any night with £5 in your pocket, bribe two metropolitan policemen, and still have change. A man in jeans is very likely a plumber. Time and nostalgia have given TW3 the reputation of being shocking and revolutionary. You're unlikely to be shocked or revolted tonight. Time plays other tricks. Old memories grow rosy, old outrages appear inoffensive. In any case, shock, horror, and scandal were never the great virtues of TW3. Rather listen for the quality of the writing and the attitude to events and issues. If there was ever a writer's show, this was it. Abetted and enhanced by an extraordinarily brave and talented cast who never picked up their scripts before Friday. Everything changes and everything is the same. Today we have an alliance party. In 1962 there was a liberal revival at Orpington. India invaded Goa, and Portugal, lacking a woman prime minister, did not send a task force. Traffic jams and unemployment were up, nurses' pay was not. April Ashley, whose autobiography came out this year, was becoming famous as the first Englishman to go abroad and come back abroad. The BBC was not 60, it was 40, but by God they were celebrating it with the same fervour. It's not for us to say whether we have the influence on television or on events with which some people have credited That Was the Week. What is certain is that there was a great communion between public and programme makers on Saturday night. Two footnotes. At the end of the programme, you'll hear David Frost refer to Hugh Gaitskell's health. Gaitskell was on a routine hospital visit, and the news was that he was on the mend. Tragically, he died a few days later, but the programme was a live conversation with its audience, so we haven't cut the joke, which left us with egg on our face. Second, you will recognize and enjoy most of the performers. One, the very talented and dearly loved cartoonist Timothy Birdsall died very young in the middle of the series of which he relished being a part. 20 years on, he's still missed and treasured, so perhaps the rest of us who made these odd, scrappy, pertinent, petulant, ultimately serious and, we hope, funny programs, and the BBC, who after all gave us house room and support, perhaps we might dedicate this repeat of one episode, a review of the year 1962, to Tim's memory.
This is BBC Television.
With Humphrey Bogart in the classic adventure Casablanca. That's on Sunday afternoon at 5 to 2. There's a whole new look to Saturday evening with BBC One. Noel Edmond shows how late he lies in by having his late breakfast show at 6.35. Terry Wogan's back with a new rib-tickling series of Blankety Blank at 7.15. The call sign Juliet Bravo goes out for Inspector Jean Doubley at 7.50. Summertime Special brings together Max Bygraves, Lulu and Rocky Sharp and the replays at 8.40. The Saturday film at 9.25 stars Ryan O'Neill as the driver and Bruce Dern as the detective out to get the best getaway man in the business. Karen's back at 11.10 and at midnight the Doobie Brothers are late night in concert. Well, this is the point where we part company for the night. It's also the end of BBC One's week celebrating 60 BBC years. So we'll round it off the way the television service used to close in the 50s with the final strains of the television march by Eric Coates. Have a very pleasant weekend from us at the BBC Television Centre. Good night for now.